awesome stuff today. Let's see what she is. Wow.
What is it? Wheeler Bros.
You know it?
Yeah.
Thanks. See what that one is.
I bet you it's a Scott's emulsion or something. It's alright. The clay's deceiving.
Low mass.
Yep. Lime.
GI Hood and Co.
Yep. It's sarsaparilla.
Nice.
Some here.
Usual culprit.
I'm in a construction trench currently. I was up here earlier and I found about 1870s sodas and 1870s beer. I'll show you guys after they're all cleaned up, but it's pretty great. It's kind of hard to beat that. She's that different very look to her, you know? She doesn't have the mug base. That's what I was referring to. I think that's the first one I've ever found that's not mug based.
Yeah.
Well, if that's there, you could definitely be quart ales and stuff. Working on some type of flask.
Hoping she's whole.
Oh, yeah, she's got a lot of shit around her. It's gonna be a miracle if she is. See though. I'm tapping something underneath her too.
Be very careful. We'll get back at you. We're just showing you that this is actually in here. Possibly the most pain in the ass thing to ever pull. We'll see if she's good still.
Wow. How in hell did that survive?
What does it say?
Pike's Peak.
Wow.
Celebrated like Pike's Peak. It's a decent 1870s and 60s. It's pretty fucking cool.
Possibly the most pain in the ass thing to ever pull. We'll see if she's good still.
Wow. How in hell did that survive?
What does it say?
Pike's Peak.
Wow.
Celebrated like Pike's Peak. It's a decent 1870s and 60s. It's pretty fucking cool. Very old hole.
We have another thing sticking out too we're gonna get out. So, get back at you.
Is it ready?
No. Chicago soda.
A smooth base. I think it's a blob. Blob top soda.
It's pretty wedged. I have to give it more time.
Alright. Mike, move your hand. We'll get back at you.
It's still pretty wedged.
Hey, it's a beer. Video of it cleaned up. Alright, we got another one.
cautious about what's around it because I don't want to.
This pit has almost every Chicago soda smooth base, and so far this is the first iron pottle we've found, which is absolutely insane. You could see, look at the wow,
show the camera. It's my second iron pottle
cobalt soda you've ever found.
Yeah.
Oh, it's unreal. Alright, well, we'll get back at you. So it just popped off. Hayes Bros.
True Live.
Put it in the center of here. Right here. Hayes Bros. True Live. We're gonna keep going. We got a lot of more to go.
We got a bottle showing. Work on it a little bit. She's attacked. You know, I've got my tool. I got lost within everything else, unfortunately. So bear with me. Kind of going a little blind at this one. Yeah. We got three privies here. Michael's working on one and I'm working on one now too, just to kind of get some of these wrapped up. We've got a limited time on this site. Let's see. Not Pottle. Let's see, is she gonna be embossed? No, but still very crude. Three-piece mold. Pretty cool.
Keep going. Broken cobalt J. Lomax hutch. I think this is a clear variation of that same hutch. She's wedged them pretty well. Oh wow, it's actually all those weird English.
Is it like melted?
No, the top shattered off a bit. I think Lomax did make some of these weird ones. It is a Lomax. this up. I mean, it's broke, but still kind of cool. I don't know if, what you want to call that style.
Well, find out.
Wow. Got it. I think it's ink. Let's see if it says anything. Slick. It says something on the bottom. The glass maker. M&S. Nice.
Well, I got back on the construction site and pulled some more out of the pile. They had filled in the trench we were digging in.
Roth and Cook.
Here's a bunch that
we... Amberg and Stetson. D. Dempsey. Hutches.
Hallsberg. Hayes Bros. Hutches. Hayes Bro. True Blob. Another five panel WHH. And then a Stoneware Beer F. Lehman. So, we'll get a picture of it all cleaned up.